So these corns are meant for poultry feed. Corns, you know that bhutta we call it. So that seeds were there to feed whom? To feed the poultries. So most of it had been devoured by rats. So much of these corns were eaten up by the rats. I saw nothing but husks and dusts in the bag. So what did he see? He saw nothing, only some dust in the bag. So dust of what? Dust of corns were there in the bag. I emptied the contents outside my wall. This was a little time before the great rains. A month later, I discovered green stalks shooting out of the ground. So what did he do with this husk and dust in the bag? He scattered it on the ground. And after a month, what did he discover? He discovered green stalks or green shoots coming out from the ground. I was astonished. Astonished meaning surprised. To discover it was perfect green barley. So as he scattered all the husk and dust from the bag into that ground, what did he see? Green stalks of barley coming out on the ground. So by the June of 1660, I had gained security of food and shelter. So 1660, it's an important date, you must remember. What he had gained? Security of food. So he had food, he had shelter. So shelter where? Shelter near that cave where he pitched his tent, and food with barley and all the provisions that he is going, that he is bringing into his cave or into his safe habitation. So in this same month, I developed a high fever and lay weak and thirsty. So in that same month, in the month of June, so he had developed high fever and lay weak and thirsty. I recovered around 38th and gradually felt stronger than the day before. So he recovered on 38th of June and felt stronger than the day before. Come on to the next page. On 15th of July, I took a more particular survey of this island. So this island was still unknown to him. He had not completely surveyed the whole island. So what did he do? After getting strong from his fever, he on 15th of July, he tried to survey the various parts of the island. So around 2 miles, I found a brook. Brook is a stream, a river, with pleasant meadows by its bank, plains smooth and covered by grass. So its bank, so pleasant meadows. Meadows is what? A ground. By its bank, plains smooth and covered by grass. So in a woody part, I found melons in great abundance and grape trees. So near that brook, what did he find there? He find melons, grape trees. The grapes were ripe and rich. Further into the land, I found a greater number of cocoa, orange, lemon trees. So these are all the things important. What did he found exploring more? He found so many things. He found melons, he found grape trees which were ripe and rich. Suppose the question can come, how were the grapes? The grapes were ripe and rich. And farther into the land, I found a great number of cocoa, orange, lemon trees. I carried great parcels of fruit homeward, and the journey took me 3 days. Okay, so as you know, he had made the box with the wood. So in that box, he used to keep everything, preserve everything that he used to bring at a time and preserve there. I was tempted to transfer my habitation to this valley of fruits. So he was very much tempted. Okay, tempted to transfer means he was staying as we know that he had pitched his habitation near that cave. So he wanted to transfer his habitation to where? To this valley of fruits. I did not. Why? Because I still hoped to be rescued by some passing ship on the sea. So he was near to the sea. So he tried to stay there only. If he comes inside the forest, then people who would be passers-by from that area would not be able to see him. So that is why he chose to stay there only and not to come to the Valley of Fruits. I did not want to enclose myself in hills and woods. I stayed in view of the sea. 10 months had passed since I had set foot on this island. So by the passage of time, how many months have been passed? 10 months. Previously, I had no lamp. After dark, I collected a little tallow. Tallow is a small animal fat, okay, used to make candles, means charbi we call. So that is used to that is inflammable, and if fire is burned, it catches fire, okay. And small cliff dish. To add this, I added a wick. I had thus made myself a lamp. So with the help of tallow and a small clay dish, he made a lamp. He made fire. I now began to seriously consider the circumstance I was reduced to. I decided to describe my state of affairs in writing. So he wanted to journal, means copy down every each and daily works in a journal, in a diary. I began to keep a journal of everyday's employment. Everyday's employment means everyday's work, what he was doing, what, how he was surviving each and every day, that he was copying down in a notebook. I could not include all particulars because gradually I ran out ink. So I could not include all particulars means he could not give all the details in the journal as his ink had ran out. So he was ink finished. As we have already studied before, that he got ink and paper from that wrecked ship. So there, after drawing the paper, he used to write over there. I found by the notches I cast on the post, it was September 30th again. I had spent 365 days on this island. So on previous September 30th, he landed, and after he saw, means he came, it came into his account that he had lived there for 1 year. Question and answers will be provided to you in the next class. So I hope you have understood the chapter. It's nothing, it's about the survival of Robinson Crusoe in a dismal or a desolate, or you can say lonely island. How did he survive himself there? It's a very good example of this chapter. If you want to watch a film on this, you can also have a look at Castaway. The name of the film is Castaway. So if you get any time, please do watch the tutorial in the YouTube. The film name is Castaway. You will get the idea. Okay. Thank you.